Charbs, maybe you heard about this in the news. The artist Maurizio Cattelan duct taped a banana to the wall at Art Basel in Miami Beach. This sculpture was then given the title The Comedian and sold in a limited edition for $120,000. Only three of them could be sold, and they came with a letter of authenticity. People had a lot of feelings about this. In this video, I'm just going to try to explain what happened, but I'll note that with all art and most, if not all, media in general, I have a bias for assuming good intentions. I try to enter the world by looking at things that others make and appreciating them. This would make me a bad critic, but I think it makes me a more pleasant person to get a cup of coffee with. So I go into something like this, trusting the artist. Maurizio Cattelan is mostly retired. You may have seen some of his other work. He famously made a golden toilet called America that was stolen earlier this year and is still missing. He sculpted a likeness of a pope being struck by a meteor. If you've been to Milan, perhaps you've seen his giant middle finger outside of the stock exchange. If you're really in the know, then you might be aware that this is not the first time Cattelan has duct taped something to the wall of a gallery. About 10 years ago, he duct taped the gallery owner to the wall. So in some ways, the sculpture needs to be viewed in the context of the artist's history. The gallery owner has been replaced by a banana. I don't quite know what that means, but it does give me something to think about. It's a visual analogy that I think I need to sit with for a little bit longer. I mean, I think it might have something to do with the fact that the banana is phallic imagery, so perhaps he thinks the gallery owner is a big. I don't think I need to say it. Speaking of the gallery owner, this appeared in the booth operated by Emmanuel Perrotin, a dealer known for specializing in high-priced, some might say overpriced, art. And Art Basel generally has been criticized for being a show for billionaires. I can't help but think that this comedian is yet another artist making fun of the absurd pieces of contemporary art selling for millions. I say another because Banksy has made headlines all year with that message. People are saying that this banana is everything wrong with the art world, and I'm pretty sure the comedian would agree with that. It's easy to read into this work that it is criticizing the way buyers are paying millions of dollars for works that will, in this case, literally rot away and fade out of cultural consciousness. Buyers of this piece can, of course, replace the banana. They have the letter of authenticity regardless, so I assume that whoever bought this piece will also have to hire somebody to replace the banana and duct tape pretty regularly. And maybe that's the joke of the comedian. Maybe it's all just messing with the gallery owner who specializes in selling million-dollar art. The people who bought this banana purchased something that represents the joke that is on them. Many others have interpreted it this way as well, including the award-winning art critic Jerry Saltz, who said stunts like this account for a full 1% of 1% of 1% of the art world. Meanwhile, for the 99.999%, we beat on against the tide in this urgently beautiful pursuit. Stuff like this makes the headlines and promotes a belief that the art world is totally out of touch with reality. But like with most things these days, that part of the art world that makes headlines does not represent the art world. This work of art was lazy. It was unoriginal. A banana peel was used as a sculpture in 2008 by the artist Adriana Lara. Actually, that's not a fair criticism. Everything is a remix. I take that back. It's original. It is cynical, though. I'll stand by that. And I think a good argument could be made that Catalan knows this and wants to call attention to it. He has made a career of giving the middle finger to, well, most things. It's the only thing posted on his Instagram, for example. His website mostly consists of a game with a middle finger that shoots fire. The other notable event surrounding the banana was the obviously self-serving and self-promotional move by the artist David Datuna, who took the banana off the wall and ate it for his Instagram followers. Cool, man. Enjoy the press. A spokesperson for the gallery told the Miami Herald that Datuna did not destroy the artwork. The banana is an idea. The banana is an idea. I laughed pretty hard when I read that for the first time. I mean, of course the banana is an idea, but let's say it's not for a second. Or at least let's say that if it is an idea, that it's the idea of a banana. Let's say that the banana isn't, in this case, a phallic symbol or a joke. Just for the sake of conversation, let's say that the banana is a banana. In the past 100 years, a startlingly large number of banana cultivars have gone extinct. It's possible to envision a world where bananas are rare, so an environmentalist reading of this piece might be that the banana is destined to become something the rich buy and display because it will be a status symbol through scarcity. Maybe that's the comment. I don't know. I guess it's fun that Catalan gave us something to respond to over the weekend and have a conversation about. More on that in a future video. Subscribe if you want to be notified when I publish that new one, and thank you for watching.